So welcome to Bunny's Designs. This is a live show with live peoples, and I'm playing in my UG tablet, which is just a tablet, but what it does, it allows you get a couple of pens with this particular UG. And for the life of me, I can't remember which one it is. You have a look in the box. And you do get a hand guard, but a two-finger guard, but I've put mine somewhere. So you can actually put a dust cloth that you clean your glasses with. That would be fine. Or you can just put this on your hand to stop your marks getting onto your hands. So some tablets, but this doesn't seem to bother it, my hands, so that's quite nice. So you get this particular one is. You get two pens, which I thought was wonderful, and they're very light, they're very easily balanced, and they've got like a rubberized coating on them, so you don't have to grip them, and you can basically just scratch the top. And I do you do get let me just tell you which one this one is before I forget. This is a HK 1560 interactive pen display. And I looked at a lot of hours of. I put both pens in there, so that won't go. And you get two chargers, which you just plug in, and two. You get two plugs as well. So I was really impressed you got two plugs. You also get this little stand to stand your pen in, or you can stand your pen on the little lips. So it's always next to you, or it's always handy, and it's not rolling away. Now my desk's on a slant, so I'm just struggling at a little bit with this. So I had a look at everybody, and I was almost. I ordered three times and then didn't press the magic Amazon Gremlin button to buy a Wacom Cintiq. Sorry, not the Cintiq, the tablet, and it was about this size, and it has buttons. But it's black, and what you do is you draw on a black pad, and your image comes on your laptop. And they were about £250, which was my limit, really. It was over my limit, but it was my limit because it was my Christmas present. And I really wanted it because it had the tilt control and it did everything I wanted it to do. But I thought, how difficult is it for me to learn to kind of pat your head and rub your belly at the same time? So you're not actually drawing on what you can see. So I decided that for the same price, although Wacom are the best, I would look at the second best. And I say looked at a lot of box openings and reviews, and I came up with this one, which is the UG. It comes in a 20 and a 20 something inch, a bigger one. Or is this 15? No, I think this is 20. And there's a bigger one. And I really would have liked the bigger one, except. I want to take this to model shows. I want to take this anywhere I want. It's quite light. It will sit on, I sit it on my cushion tray when I'm on the sofa. And I have my laptop on a little table next to me, and that's all I need. Apologies about the fan. It's the best recording laptop, but it's the noisiest one. And I did buy some headphones, but I couldn't seem to get them to work with it. I bought some Logitech headphones. So what when I do my YouTube live, because I use OBS and you can't do that with Ustream, or I can't get it to work. So the digital show will be on YouTube, but it will be live, and hopefully I'll be able to use my microphone. So the software does not come with it. You have to have a play. This is a free ArtRage, which I love because it's very easy. And you can buy the Bennett Klein books, coloring books, and buy them digitally, so they just download automatically. I didn't. I photocopied. I scanned mine in. So mine are a little bit kind of grainy and more coloured than they would be. So they're not, it's not a very good thing, but it's just to keep me occupied. I will be going through the different types of. Oh, just bear with me. Do excuse me. Hello? Sorry about that. So, right, wait a second, cancel that one. So I'll go through the different art ones, but just at this minute, I'm in outrage. So again, I watched a lot of YouTube videos. I've downloaded this one. I probably will buy this one because I like it. There's a couple of ones that I really like. I can't afford Coral Painter for professional artists because it's £300 and I can't afford that. But I love this one. It has a tool setting here. It has a color setting here. I've set it up with a little sample and a reference. So as I'm zoomed in and coloring, as you'll see, it'll change here. So you have an overall. But what you can also do is scan in a photograph or any kind of image you want to draw. I'll paint from instead of coloring in, and your image is there, and you have a reference instead of having a picture over the top. You can actually scan it in and have it there. And you can make it bigger and larger. And you draw your image and you carry on. So basically, you've got a wide brush, which is oil brush, you've got a watercolor brush, you've got a palette knife, airbrush. I think that's it says it's a technical pen for drawing. You've got stamps, you've got a Gloop pen. I like the felt pen and I have it set. This is what I normally work with, and I have it set as I have it as a blending marker because I like that. So it's a blending marker, and you can play with the water settings and everything else. We've then got a roller, a pencil, a pastel. This one, if you just hover over the top, it tells you. It's not going to do it, but it's a cloner, so it pushes things together. An eraser, tubes quite good. Tubes of paint, so you can squirt paint out like it's a tube and just mush everything together. And then there's a glitter pot, glitter tube. There's text fill. I think this is color sampler, which I don't know what that is, but never mind. I don't want it. What does that one say? That's transform. And selection. So if I've drawn something and it's in the wrong place, but it's good, it's correct, but it's just out, I can make a line round it and move it in its right place. But I'll do a proper drawing one later. So this is just, and I just can't see the date on that one. Just bear with me. Right. So I don't have it on metallic. You can have it on metallic, so that makes everything kind of shiny. And as you're drawing, if you touch the edge, it'll disappear, which is quite nice, especially if you're. So wherever you go, it'll disappear. And I think, oh, is it that one? That one. You can work the complete screen. There is a little kind of a compass thing here, so you can turn your page. So you know I have this thing about turning your page, so your hand is just working in its full control. This helps you do that, and you can also zoom in and zoom out. If you press the top little triangle, it automatically takes it to its original position, and you can zoom back into your 100%. So you don't need that one. The only one I use it for is the back tool, and I haven't found out where that is. You can set the buttons on here to go for erase or back. I haven't managed to do that yet, so I'm just going to take that back because I've got two lines on here because I scripted across. So I keep this, and you don't need to press a button and move that, but what you can do is touch your button and move it if it's in the way. Whoops, come on, do as you're told. come on, do as you're told. That's it, I've got it now. So I don't need a lot down here apart from just changing the size of the brush. I like a smaller brush. So I'll zoom in and I'm going to do a hair because I've got some yellows and goldens up here. And you tap and it'll keep your colours for you, so you can select half a dozen to go with the yellow hair. Kind of go a bit yellower if you wanted. So you can put a few tones in, because I kind of forget my colours, so that's why I use it. I can move her across, and I'm going to start at the bottom of the ponytail here. And whatever I do on here is going to show up on my little viewer here. And again, you can move that completely out of the way. So I'm left-handed, so I would have things on my left side, but you can't move this. You can on some things. So I think I want kind of a that's kind of a shadowy. So I've got the blending tool, the blendable marker, and I kind of just push some colour. This is not a quick cheats way. This is just the same as it's a little bit quicker, but that's because you're not getting another pen out. I'm just tapping. If I want a highlight or some colour, I just tap. If I want to go back to that colour again, I just tap. I took the wrong one there. Again, if you go wrong, it's quite nice. You just hit the back button. I normally just work with one colour, and then I kind of then go back in with, I get go all over with one colour, and then I go back. And I probably use my hand a lot more, but it's a lot easier because I'm just sliding across the top. There's no pressure. And it looks a little bit blurry, but then when you go back to a normal size, it isn't. And it makes it a little bit more realistic, which I quite like. So if I wanted to just tilt that very carefully, I can keep that lovely natural flow. And just put a bit of a highlight on that one, just that little bit more colour. I can work with a lot smaller brush if I really wanted to, just a 1%. As I say, this is not a cheats way. This is just as artistic, and you've got to know what you're doing. It's just like picking up a different pen. You see, I've gone over there. That's the only nicest thing about this. Is if you make a mess of it, you can actually go back. I think that's maybe that little bit too green. This is a smaller pen now. This is the 1%, so it's a really tiny pen. But that can give me some quite nice effects if I want. I'm not sure if that it's coming through probably as a bit too yellow. So go back and have a look at her hair. We're going to make her a blonde. So normally I would just stay with one colour. And I do about 300, 400s. A bit much. I do about 300%, but as you say, what I do is I then, and you just literally, I'm not even holding it that way, which hurts me. So I can just stroke that, and I do tend to take a little bit of the black off, and blend that in a bit. I like to just blend that in. It just makes them that little bit more. And it blends into the actual, it's just like blending as you would if you had some black. And I really like that. And just turn that back round again. And you can just work in some really nice, precise way, which I kind of like to work. It does look a little bit blurry at this point, but it's because you've zoomed in. I just hope I'm in. I just hope everybody can see what I'm doing. And it allows me to play with felt pens, which I can't do, and blendable markers. So I think that's quite wonderful in a way. And I just carry on like this. So it takes the same amount of time. I mean, because this takes longer than how I normally work, because I go back into this and have a play with it. And I'm moving up and down with this little pen. And I was quite impressed that the first time I turned it on and I put my pen down, it's in exactly the right place, which everybody said it wasn't. Well, mine was. So whether they've upgraded it or done something, I don't know, but the little marker on the screen is spot on. So you can get some quite good accuracy. And you know, I put more color where I want it, like you would with a blendable pen. As I say, I love this because I love this pen. I've done four colors with it now. And you can play with this. So what I will probably do is colour this in. I mean, I don't know how long it's taken me to do the plait, but I just sit and I would say scratch, slide, scrape across, but I'm not digging in. If I did dig in, I'd get more colour. But I don't actually want more colour. I actually like building the colour up by just gently sliding the pen across the surface, which is probably a lot more strokes than I would normally do if I was working with a traditional watercolour, because I like things to be fairly quick. So I'm going to go with this all the way up to the top of her plait. And I say this blends, it's a blendable marker, and I've got it to half. The water set so I can blend in some of that dark to automatically. The only thing I don't like, it does look a bit blurred because it's a blender. It's not a blurrer, but then when you put it back to its normal size, it's fine. Can see that. The other thing is I love this because even I can do it. I can't do it with my left hand, but I can do it with my right hand. There is a little button and you just tilt it. So you can have it there, there. This is quite a nice angle. This is a really nice angle. It's probably 45 degrees, but that's really nice because you can, I know I say there's two between 200 and 300 I play with there. So I don't know if you can still see what I'm doing, but it is just a really nice angle. You do say get a little glove that fits over two fingers. So these two fingers are in a glove that goes on your hand. So you're not putting any natural oils from your hand on here, but the last couple of days I've lost it. I don't know what I've done with it. So, but you can cut an old pair of tights up, an old pair of gloves. There is actually a video of a lady that does that. If you Google that, if you search for that on YouTube, I actually bought one. In fact, I've got two because I actually bought one. Mine was £8, because my laptop has a touch screen, so actually I didn't need this. You can get ArtRage on your Apple iPads and all sorts of other things and colour there. I'm not sure about using a Bennett Klein or any other kind of digitally produced colour book. But if you can scan in on your other things, then you can scan in. So, as I said, this is what I normally do. I just have a little bit of a play, get the feel for what I'm using. So this is hair. So I get, like you would normally, get a colour down. And then when I've finished this, I probably do this type of work all over, like I did with the frog and the girl. I get it in a nice position. Again, there's no colour under it, it's black. So I'm gonna I lighten it up. I just get this colour where I want it. Now, probably she's too blonde, but never mind. If you don't like it, I can change it. And I've made that too black because it's quite dark. So I'm just gonna, a little tap will take one off, a bigger tap will take all of it. I'm actually just gonna go where it's paler, I think. Because I'm gonna have a darker one do the very black. And then here is darker, and then there's gonna be a highlight on this side. But this is because the Bennett Kleins are grayscale. It wouldn't be like this in a normal colour book. You'd have to start from scratch and think about your highlights. But it's a really nice way of working. As I say, you can't do it in the car, but you can do it anywhere you've got a plug socket. So you need two plug sockets, one for the laptop, and it will work from Windows or it will work from anything. Think it goes from Windows 7, I think. So I can use it on my little Diddy one, and again, I just turn that round just because it's easier for me. And as I said, I always like to turn the page. So this is perfect for me. And there's, as I say, there's a lot of strokes here, but there's no pen tops to take on and off. There's no pencils to drop on the floor. I've got everything at a touch of a button, and I kind of like that. I have to say, it's quite good. So I'll just do our hair, and then so again, I can just scroll down. So what I'll do is actually put it down so it's flatter. So if it goes to be almost flat. I was gonna have a mouthful of coffee, sorry. So I think a lot of these people that do this, the artist, proper artists, actually speed paint. And I think you don't know what settings they're using. And I know some people don't want you to copy exactly. But I wanted to show what this was like, just kind of using it as a a novice. It's like when you get a new set of pens and pencils. At first you think, oh, I can't do this, but ArtRage is a really nice one to play with. And they give you this demo, and I think it's an unlimited demo. You can't keep a lot of your work. Oh, it says you can't, but I can keep mine. I don't know why I can keep mine. I do, as I say, intend to buy this because I really like it. But I like Critter. Critter will be better when I do my own artwork. So I'll be using probably Critter for my art in the Abbey. So I'll be design drawing the I'm going to do the windows, I think, first to get me back into drawing. Again, you just kind of move about a bit, and all the time the image is here. So we've got to kind of think very soon. I've got to think this has got to kind of go into a paler color now. Just do this little bit because obviously in a minute it's got to go into a pale mousy color, a more kind of not mousy, because badgers are black and white, but we're going to have to make him take this almost to white. So again, if I turn that round, I should be able to get a highlight on there. Or come back later and do that. So again, I can go to a bit paler now. And it hurts my hands a little bit, I have to say, because I'm doing a lot more. I'm doing a lot more work. So it's bound to, but the beauty of it is I can just do this. And I've actually found myself scribbling down, which I kind of stopped myself. So, and I could work with, I mean, I've got 1% on here. I could probably work up. If I go to a 10%, it's a lot easier. This is, oh sorry, it's on 1%. I don't know why it's on 1%. That's on 5%. 5% is quite nice. And what you can then do is blend these colours together, so I can take that really down white. The only thing to remember is if you make a mistake, you've got to take it off there, because if you carry on, you, unless you can fix it by going over it, you won't be able to fix you won't be able to go back. It'll take, you've got to take everything off. So you've just got to remember that. But again, you can see that really nice blend. And I'll probably take off that yellow. I think probably that's, she can be a strawberry blonde rather than a peroxide yellow blonde, probably. So as you would blend pencils, and this is where you can bring your highlights in then. And then you can go back and see how it's looking. Whether that is too yellow, or you can drop this size if you want to, but I like to have a bit more detail. Oopsie. So I normally draw about 300. So we can give her, and I say you, it's probably a lot more work, but it's easier with the pen tops, if that makes sense. So again, what I could do is just see if I could really get a nicer highlight on there. And as I say, you know, you can go up to, you don't have to, I've just got a little tiny mark on that pen, but then you see you can build up colour. And I'm going to take that back actually, because I don't want that to go up there. I want that to be white. So I'm taking this to here, and this kind of bit under here, because that looks like hair. But then when it goes to fur, and it's not plaited, I'm going to take it to even a lighter colour. So that is doing quite well. I shouldn't be doing this, I should be doing it easier for me. And then just, and that is just scratching across. So I've got to learn not to kind of scribble down like I've been doing. So Again, I take that round to there, and I think I like that as to white. Then it's going from there almost to white. So what we could do, I do have a fairly large brush now, but we could go to the purple and have just save that one. I really want the blacks not to be black. That isn't black, it's a purple. So if I go into my, which I think is under there, into my settings, it's not going to do that. I can kind of need a bit of a different color, so I'll have that one. So that's a little bit lighter. Still want it on the black, the blacky side though, really. That's slightly better. Again, you can blend that around. So you've got a lot of blending to do. You've got a lot of work to do, and you've got a lot of thinking to do. It's and then you actually want that to kind of blend in. If you can see, I'm actually putting a highlight on there. So you can put a highlight in. You can take that down there if you want to. So you can take off the black line if you want. And again, I quite like that. So this is almost a pinky, warmy white. So let's just go back over here and see what's going to happen if we take that into there. So that works quite well. So I go over all the white again. It's not, you know, I don't leave that. Blend that in. And take that down there, because now we've got our natural highlight that we want to incorporate with our hair. And that works quite well. And it softens the shadow. But as I say, I think that's because my downloads weren't particularly brilliant. And then you can build that little bit of highlight back up again and pop another one anywhere else you want it. Now, as I say, this is a bit thick. This is 13 and I was working on 0. And you're just kind of working in the same area, so I find that quite nice as well. So if I turn that back around and put it down to 100%, there's a quite a nice highlight in there. And can take that up here. So I'm taking that stark white. I always like to take the stark white off. Make that nose that little bit more blendable, and again, I like to turn it so it's a natural. So, as I say, it's not a quick cheats flick, it's another way of working, but it gives you the opportunity to work in mediums that you can't always do. And I quite like that for that reason. So I'm just going to blend that in and take that up. It does leave a little bit of a line because it did that on there. But when you, if you look on here, you can't see it. It's just knocking that stark white off. So you can make that bigger if you wanted. If you press down, you get a different effect. And that's a very large brush. And sometimes I don't really like using a large brush. Depends what you want to do. See, it's smudging all that. So I'm going to take that off because I don't like it. Probably about let's have a look what 30 is. 30 is okay for a big area. So that's a bit easier on your hands. So if you have a bigger area, although you wouldn't have, if you were doing it traditionally, of course, you wouldn't have a bigger area because you would be working at this size. So you wouldn't be working. And you know, this is, you can't really get a lot. You could do, I suppose, if you wanted, but it's too blurry, see, for me, is that. So if I take that off, put it to 300. Now this is a little bit of a bigger brush. So it's blending the wrong thing. So I'm going to take my brush back down because I like a thinner brush. Whoopsie, so I probably want about a 6. So that means you've got, and you can pop it further down, you can put it anywhere you want it really. So when you now touch that black, it's not going to blur unless you want it to. So we've got to think about his dark colour now. So I'm just thinking about introducing a little bit of this purple colour. And using purple instead of black. That will warm things up quite a lot. So, although I'll have my little tablet with me, I've got inks, airbrush, and again, I can't do airbrush because I've got asthma. So, I have an airbrush that I've bought and I can't use it. So, I can now use an airbrush tool because I used to use airbrush when we did graphic design. We had a few weeks course on how to use airbrush. We had a year's course on photography, and actually developing our and we just finished. Because we didn't do colour. Otherwise we'd have done colour, photography, production as well. And it's come back into fashion and I love it. Absolutely love it. So I'm just going to take that little bit of black off there just to give that, make that a bit warmer. And again, if you look at it and you think, oh, that's too purple, then you can take it off. But again, you could just see sometimes if you tap, you get dots. If you take that right down to two, then you can just have a little tiny bit. And then what you can do is go back to the pale one, oh, to this one. Now, the other thing I love about, there's another art software called Sai, which is SAI, and that's for graphics and manga and things. And that's very good for colouring. I'll use that. And that has a fantastic thing. You push down on a colour, anywhere, and it gets it into the end of your pen. So then you start colouring. Because if I've forgotten that whatever colour this was, I push down and I select that colour and I can use it somewhere else. And that to me was pretty amazing. And again, I think this was probably down here, but I didn't keep it. So I'm just going to blend that away. I quite like that. So if I now say go back into that and take it back down to 100, I've just warmed that area up a little bit. This is how I work normally. This is how I work non-digitally, should I say. So, has anybody got any questions? So, that's taken me about 30 minutes. So, it's a couple of hours for a page, which is about right. And so I do use that button probably better than this one, really. I should know better, but hey go. So, this highlight here, I'm actually going to use. Here, I think. I don't know which one. I don't think I maybe saved that one. Maybe I didn't save that one. So I can knock this a little bit so it's not quite as yellow. But it's still bright, and again, I can turn it right round and really have a nice natural kind of. And you can, and again, you can draw for hours like this, so I really like this way of working. So I'm just getting rid of that kind of bright yellow, and I can now incorporate that up to the top. I say I've now got a number 2% paintbrush, so that's quite a fine paintbrush. So I would think that's almost like a pencil, but it's quite nice that you can blend in. And I do tend to go over all the black as well. It's not very often I don't. I do try. So I've actually put a natural highlight in there. So let's turn it round and see if it looks wrong. There's some highlight here, and possibly it wants to be maybe a little bit darker, but that highlight would be perfect at the top. I don't know, I might leave that and oopsie, sorry, sometimes you've got to be a little bit careful what you're doing. Because I can now take it almost to the white. If I keep that to there, then take that to the white, that's going to give me that natural progression. I just don't need to do it as much, probably. it wants to be this color rather than any other color, really. And sometimes I really want to get rid of that black line, but if you go too far, you see, you end up with a highlight, which you may not actually want up there. And now we've got to the white, so we can take that down now. And we can take back anything we want. So it's very similar like traditional oils. You kind of blend one way, then you blend back the other way, and then you blend back, and that's how you get your lovely blends. And that, it's very similar. So you can take a little bit of that white. And very similar to the pastels. So I can think my thumb's getting a bit thingy because I'm again scribbling it down. I can feel myself. I've got to learn not to do that. So this is a learning curve, and I say it's not a cheat's way. You've still got to think artistically. You've still got to think, what is the pen going to do? What can it do? In fact, it's worse in some ways, because you can probably get a pen and a pencil to work in about six different ways. Each particular thing in here, you can get to work 100 ways. So actually, it's more difficult. You have more choice, and so it's always more difficult when you've got more choice. Which is why I tend to just work with a thin little pen and just purely use colour, and that's what I do. I would work differently if I was doing my own art, but because I'm just colouring in, this works really simply and easiest for me. Again, I'm just taking that white into there. But I can't stream live doing this without some kind of glare, so I can't get OBS to work with Ustream. I'm not sure why, but I can't. And then I can touch this purple that I've got up here. And really accentuate these shadows now. Just with the tiniest bit of colour, which is that really deep purple. I've gone over there, so you can see you've got to be a bit careful. It's not scribble. So now I need to go back over that one and kind of blend that back. Put the highlight back in. So it's like oils, you know, put your highlight in, put your dark one in, and go back again until you get it exactly where you want it and blended so it looks more natural. But as I say, the beauty of it is you can just keep pressing that blue, and I'm actually putting the highlights in with the paler one because that's kind of naturally getting rid of that kind of yellow that I wasn't particularly keen on. Tiny bit of purple in there, in here. So it's a traditional way of working with non-traditional tools. That's the easiest way I can, that's the easiest way I can describe it. To kind of just taking that purple, oops, back to the black, and then the black is disappearing and we have the warmer purple colour, but it leaves a nice shadow, because I've always said never use black. And again, this is quite nice here. We got the bit paler purple, didn't we, on here? And again, it's very well behaved, it just disappears. This is the bit paler colour purple. This is the paler purple, and then you can go back into this one. Oh, the darker one. You can just keep going in and playing. It's quite therapeutic. Again, I do like to be what I call the right way around. So you can get that highlight back, and then you've got that purple shadow. And any shadow that's not black is a nice shadow. Big in the sky. We don't have to get things big in the sky around here. Apologies about the fan, it's a lesser of two evils. Sorry about that. I have turned the volume down quite a lot on the actual recorder. So you do need a little bit of a semblance of order. So if you start doing something one way, you need to carry on. And but if you get in a pickle, you can just always go back and think, I quite like that. It's just that little bit warmer. And of course, at this side, we've got some more pigtails, which I forgot. And I would have never been able to pick on here the same color again. So it's nice that I can go to here and I can pick this color, and I don't think it was that one. I think it was that one. Some golden highlights in here. And then as we work back down, we can take them out. And you know, you can go. I've got 2% at the moment, so that's fine. It goes pixelated, but it means you can just kind of, if you want to, get some color down. Oh, that was 500. That was too much. I thought it was a bit blurred, but again, you see, I just put the color in here. And you can see if it's working. If it's not, just go with a brownie color, make a brunette or a redhead. In fact, I think probably she could have been a redhead. Been about an hour, so I've done this. I've done 300. I'm just going to put a little bit of the dark highlight into here. And kind of just, I like to be on 1%, actually, I have to say. I don't know why. I just like the finest pen. I like my details. I do. This is a bit far away now, but there's going to be a little bit of purple on there. And then we'll go back to that one and blend it away. And then you get your highlights back again. I quite like, again, you could put your darks in first and then do your highlights. I like to get a basic color down and then put some highlights in. And if you just take it that bit further than it was, it just becomes a little bit more realistic. And so we can go back to I say apologies about the silly fan, but I cannot do anything about it. So if I push that over there. I mean, you can have lots of other things open, you can have it full of things if you want, but this is, I find, the simplest way. So I haven't done anything up here, so I've got the eye to do. And so again, you can tap there 300. So you don't need that. It's just the back button, and I can't find out where it is. No, that's not it. I don't know where it is. It's about somewhere handy, but I just can't remember where it is. Actually, you can get rid of these. There we go. Look, you can tap those and get rid of them. I thought you could. So that's saying now I've got the blendable pen and it's at 1%. Right, I think we could have, and I'm working in yellow at the moment, so I think we could have kind of a really, really, really vivid coloured eye. And then we want. If you just go over it once, you don't get rid of the. It doesn't go too purple. So all that grey highlight is now going to be blue, bluey purple. All the black is going to be warm. And as I say, I just quite like. I like taking that black. To be just that bit warmer. And this is the same colour, but I'm not using it as much. So this is the white, almost the pale. Pale pinky white. But if you scratched over it and pressed down, you would get white. But if you kind of just gently stroke over the top, it's just going to blend a bit of a highlight in. And as I say, I do tend to try and go over every single mark, every single scrap of. Of area. If you wanted to get rid of. A certain bit, you can just do that. So again, that's kind of warmed all that area up. So I think I've done most of that. I think I've done most of that. Could possibly just put maybe the tiniest little bit of colour into here. To show that, in fact, turn it around. Just to show that that was. Same part, and I think this would be in it as well. I think so. We can turn around and we can put it back to 100, and so that ear is now incorporated with that. So I did want a kind of a purple jacket for her. I'm just going to have a play with metallic. I've never played with metallic before, so we'll have a bit of a play. See what happens when we go over this. So you get some really cool effects. Or would it be this way? Just turn her around a minute. Let's start there and work backwards. So the buckles could be Metallic, maybe. Oh, that looks pretty good. But I've made a mistake because now I can't get rid of this. And I think if I use the eraser, I think I'll rub everything out. You see, I rub everything out. You don't just rub, you rub everything out. So I'm going to have to do that again, but I can't get it right. So let me just undo that a minute and have a think. If I can just gently rub then. Oops, if I just gently. Oh, let me see if I can set the eraser. Set the eraser. No, it's in settings. A soft eraser. Oh, we've got a group. Right, so we want a soft eraser because that might just take off enough that I can put another color on it. So that's going to do. In fact, I'm going to do that and I'm going to make that smaller. Going to make that 9. So I can have a bit more control over that. I think that's probably going to be better. Because I actually quite like that highlight on there, so I don't want rid of it. And turn that round bit more. Oops. And we'll just get rid of a little bit of that. So that's another way of doing it if you forget. I didn't think I'd like that as much, but I do like that buckle. And because I like the buckle, so I'm going to go back to the pen, and it should remember that I'm in metallic, 1% in metallic. It'll remember, and the eraser will remember that I'm a soft 9% eraser as well. So I think the faster we go here, that was when we got the highlight. I haven't quite mastered this metallic yet. But I really like that buckle. Don't know how it shows up, but I really like that metallic buckle. So I'm going to leave that and then I'm just going to twizzle round. So I need some kind of, not black leather, I think I'm going to go for brown. Let me have a look, I think. Me just, so let me do, I'm on metallic, so I want to take it off metallic and then to kind of just. Because leather's not really that shiny. And oops, I can just. It's 500's a bit much, 300's really better. Just. Start playing with shadow and think, well, that leather would be darker down there, paler there, and then we can return her to normal. Yes, I like that. I really like that. So again, you can start playing as much as you want. And I find that having my elbow not on here is better when I'm on the desk. But I don't often work from the desk. So we have a natural highlight there. So I get the colour down and then I start to play with it. I've got to just see if this will colour over. Otherwise, you've got to start again. I think we might just be able to get away with that one. Possibly. And again, there's a bit of metallic. Oh, the buckle work. So maybe the best thing to do is to do all the buckle work first. So we need to go to the purple, and there's a button here that you can, oops, you can chisel up to 100% metallic. This little half circle here, and then you can tell instantly what's happening. And if you press down, you get the white metallic highlight the faster you go. So that's quite nice, and I think that's the buckle there. So you should see what's happening here as well. I really like those highlights on there. Think I'd like just another bit of a highlight on this one. No, I just have to take that off a minute. And where else have we got any metal? Let me have a look. And she's got some studs here, so we can do these little metal studs. The more you press down, the shinier they are, so that is quite wonderful. You can leave the top as a natural highlight if you want. Just to turn that one off. It's obviously working. Top to bottom gives you the highlight. And we have another. It's just a bit of a subtle highlight, but I really like that. And again, I think this is a buckle, so we've got to kind of draw it as is, and then that's going to give us the highlight. I think The metallic follows the pen, if I'm thinking correctly. Maybe you should use it with a difference. But I quite like the way that it reacts. It's kind of on the third stroke, it's going to give you the metallic sheen that you get. Again, that's I think that's a buckle as well, so we'll go with that as well. Oh, thank you, kangaroo. Thank you. I was just, oh, hi. I was miles away. You do tend to go miles away. I'm just kind of having a play on my little tablet. But this is a kind of a pre-program because if you're live on YouTube, it's going to be completely different. I don't know what the chat's like, but I wanted to do live on Ustream, but I just can't get everything to work. So you're actually seeing my hand, whereas when you use the different things, you can use you just see the kind of cursor, and you don't see me at all. You just see what's on the screen, which is better in some ways. But I still want to kind of go through everything. And I'm really enjoying this metallic. And you can do all sorts. You can play for hours. But she's got any buckles? No, she's got. Oh, these must be studs. But again, I might just have to make it. Just purely to get. Not sure if this is going to work, but I can undo it this bit as long as you remember to undo things before you go any further. But I can play for hours with this, and I've got all the tools that I need at the touch of a button. And I say it's showing you what's happening here as well, so it looks like it's got quite a nice buckle effect. And the brown leather is going to look quite nice as well. I didn't really want it to be too kind of. I wanted it to be a brown leather rather than black. I originally was going to do blue, a bluey, the same colour as my blackberries, in the pastels. But I actually think the brown's going to warm it up a little bit. And again, I couldn't remember that brown, but because it's up here. I can do this brown. So that brown now appears here. So if I want a paler color for a highlight, I can just tap, and I know those two are about near the same. I can just keep tapping and getting one or two colors are about the same. But I like the blendable brush I'm using, the blendable marker. It's a felt pen, but it's a blendable marker, and that's giving me with the settings. Blending marker, it's giving me quite a nice. Oops, stand that one, and then I can find the wetness, the softness. So once I start, this is metallic, I haven't taken the metallic off it, but you can kind of it's like a marker, but it's like a wet. Oops, didn't mean to do that. It's like a I take the metallic off. You've got to remember to take these, slide the little down to zero, and then it becomes a watery brown marker. If I put that back up, it changes it so it's wetter. And I quite like that because you can keep blending. If you took that right down, it would just be a brown, it should be a brown marker that. But if you press on hard, you get a more of a marker. So I say I quite like that. And the more strokes you do, see that's just scratching like I do without any pressure. If you put pressure down, it becomes a very dark marker. But I've learned to work quite light because I like that way of working. It doesn't hurt my hands and I like it. I've messed up that buckle, I think, but oh, this is just pretend. Now this is on 29%, so you can really kind of get some blending going in a circle or in a line. You can really fill it out and then play with it later, but I tend to not want to do that. I like to play at 1%. It's my fave. I don't know why I went to 30. I actually even like it at 1%, so I've got a lot of control. So the first stroke, there's hardly anything there. But if I keep going over the same place, I just get that natural highlight going. And I find that just enough to give me a bit of difference. So that when I've been round the whole lot, see, I can start in there and drag this across, but by the time it's got right across, in fact, if I turned it right around, and again, I love this because you can just turn it to however you want it. So I'm not happy about that. So I just tap once and it's gone. And then I can, oh, it wasn't that one actually. So actually, I like that bit. So I can take it back. It was this bit that I didn't like. So I can take that off. So I want to start across here and really go for it. And because it's the same, it'll naturally pick up underneath the highlights and the lowlights. So we can go back again. So I've just got basically. And then I want to just turn them right round again because it's still the leather. And I can just go in there. And that's going to give me the full colour. And I know tablets are kind of, well, it's a few £100, but if you can't use markers, if your hands are too poorly, I've had to give most of my things away, and in order for me to keep my sanity, my husband's got me one of these. I tell a fib, I bought it and put it on his credit card, but I did have permission eventually. So when you turn it back round and take it to 100%, that's darker, even without doing anything else. And it's not quick, it isn't cheating. It's in fact it's more work, but it just makes the fact that I can play with blendable markers, I can play with oil paints, I can airbrush, I can do anything I want at a touch of a, or not even a touch of a button, at a tap. So creatively, why it's brilliant. And I use this really simple. It isn't simple. You can play with it and do what you want with it. But I've set up this really simple section that I have now. I can see what's happening, and I can zoom in, and I can turn my page, which is a real bonus because you are still using your hand a lot. Your hands still hurt a little bit because, especially if you forget and you're gripping it like a pencil. When if I forget and I just if I remembered actually just to do this with it. It would have the same effect. In fact, I might just try that. I might just try that. The Cintiqs, which are £1,500, actually have tilt control, so they know if your pencil's like this or your pen's like this. There is, I think, again, that's about 30, £20, £30, is a software called Sai, and I really love that. because it has a touch thing on it. But I'll do that tomorrow, I think. This is Art Rage, and I like this for colouring. I like this for colouring. I keep my samples up there so I don't forget what I've used. So I can go out of this and go into another one, come back to this 6 months later, but I know all my colours are up there. I love the metallic buttons, buttons and studs. I think they're fab. I've got to remember to press the little tiny button down if I want to move it. And I actually want to rotate that round. I'm just going to see if I can actually use it. And I want that kind of action, which is not going to do that there. It's going to be wrong. So she needs really to be turned round. Sorry about this. And then she tap it and move it across, and then tap it down. And that's going to give me the arc at the other side. So are we on the marker? Yeah. So again, you see, I can just do this. I should not remember to scratch down. I can just slide this over here and not hold it, particularly as a pencil. It has no real effect. Now, the Sai programs, and if you watch YouTube and type in digital software, you can watch Sai, which I'm going to probably get because I like that. And I'm going to do that for Art in the Abbey. So I'll be using Sai. I love Corel Painter, but I just can't afford it. And then there's something called, there's another one, Krita. And I love Krita, but it's going to take me a bit longer as an artist to play with that. You can set paintbrushes to hundreds of different variations. So I wanted to show this first because this is the nicest and easiest for colouring. And for colourists, it's the nicest. So I'm just scribbling the colour in because this is a bigger area. So I could use a bigger brush, but this is what it would look like probably in a marker. I probably could use a slightly bigger brush, I suppose. You just got to remember to just draw it over carefully, because I'm working as with a blendable marker. So now I can take that into there and bring that back up. So hopefully, I can bring this up in a live Ustream show, and you won't see me. You'll hear my voice through my microphone, so you won't hear the nasty fan. You won't hear the nasty fan. So I now need to kind of get these together. That looks a different brown. I don't know if I've tapped the wrong one, but never mind. It's almost a tan colour. So I need to kind of move her. It's always got to be comfortable and slide that across. Now I'm going to put some more highlights back in there. It's a bit of a block at the minute, but I did. Oops, I just need to take that off there. I did mess up a little bit. Now you can use layers and you can use all sorts of things, but I really can't be bothered. I really think I want to use it as an artist would, and I don't do layers. I just do this particular way of using a traditional pen on a traditional canvas. And I just find that works quite well. So I'm trying to get rid of the grainy effect, but it's my own fault because I'm using a larger area. And I wanted to build that up there, you see, so. Oops, I've just smudged because that's really kind of. It reacts how reality it would. So that's metallic, quite chunky paint. And so if I just smudge it, it'll just smudge across with a blendable pen. So it reacts as reality would. And that's why I like this particular program. This is a particularly nice program. So I now need a little bit darker brown just to go under there. Did I tap that one? Just to take the edge off that one. So I can bring that into there. I know possibly that this is going to be a bit darker. And then I can put a bit of a highlight on here, I think, and kind of drag that back into reality. Have a bit of a highlight on and I better turn it the right way up because I'll forget where the highlight's going. Across there, I think, possibly. And then I can go back and blend that back out if I need to. So I can set her upright. I can think that there might be a highlight on here and on there and that bit, and then possibly. Could be a kind of a bit of a highlighted space there. But I want to see if I can get that curve. And then this bit will be highlighted as well. So you just keep, as you would with felt pens, you just keep blending and. But although I'm doing the blending, I don't have any tops to take off and fine pens and pick them up. And this is a really chunky pen. But the best bit is if I make a pig's ear of it, I can just press a tap a button and it disappears. So I'm going to tap that one and I'm going to take. And again, that's just like using a third colour. Blending that in. And then if I go back to the pale again, I can take that out. Oh, that's not the palest. I didn't keep the palest then. Okay, then. I'll just take that back out here and tap. So. Even paler than that. Almost looks like a it almost looks like an oil pastel. And again, you know, we want that highlight to be here. Can take that right way across. It's not a cheat. It's not a cheat. The old digital's cheating. It's quick. It's easy. It isn't. This takes, if not longer. It's just, it's like a different. You're using traditional things digitally. Basically, that's what you're doing. And this particular art rage actually works very similar. The pens and the tools work in a traditional way. So whatever you would do traditionally, you can do with this. And that's why I like it for colouring. And again on here, I like this particular highlight now I've got, but this one doesn't have any brown, so just need to darken that one up a little bit. And it's almost a tan colour. So that's the tan, which I should have done first. And then the second highlight. And then the third highlight. Now this probably would be paler because it's higher up. It's in relief, if that makes any sense. So we can go back into here now and touch and do some wonderful. Highlights. Excuse me, I've got such a. And again, you can. The more you stroke down, the harder you stroke, your highlight becomes better. So I could go back into those metallics and actually give them quite a nice highlight. But again, I kind of like this here. Just to go into this middle. And then we have the next one, which will go next. If you get a base coat down first, you can then kind of play. And then we'll go to this one. You can bring them back in and blend and go darker, depending on where you want your highlight. So you can really make things pop. And then what you can certainly do then, and actually I've made a mistake, I think. If you look at this now, this hair is in highlight, and this is in highlight. Probably this is slightly lighter, so I might be all right. That highlight is coming from the right, and so I've got more of a highlight on that side. So now I've taken it back to its original. It looks a lot. It looks okay. As I like working at 300, but I've got actually an 8% for a bigger area, and then I'm going to actually go in here darker. So I've got a very dark one here. And you can really build this up so it's real. And if you go over the black lines, it actually becomes a painting or a proper drawing. It doesn't become. It isn't. Anymore. I don't know why I can't get that one. Quite like that one because there would be a shadow over there. You see, that's a cold shadow, that. So there would be a cold shadow under there. And again, what I should really do is practice what I preach and put the shadow exactly where it should be. Now when I turn that round, oops, I don't need to press on there, do I? So again, it's probably a little bit too dark. We want the tan because it's a tan leather. Since we've got a tan leather, we're going for it. So I say originally I was going to do the really, really. I was going to do the really, really dark purple shiny black leather, but actually I quite like this as a tan because she's in black and white, so Chicken have a tan leather. So we can put a few kind of highlights on there. And then we can make a little bit more of a highlight there. It reacts very much like oil paints, actually. I like this blended pen. It's really kind of nice to use. So we can kind of really get this highlight going on there. And we'll probably just have maybe but this is a highlight on a kind of a brown color, so I've got a very dark one under there. Again, I'm going to go back under there to kind of give that. And I would think eventually that would be. That would go into the purple up into there. So again, I kind of put this here, which I'm hoping is the tan. No, that's the tan colour. We need to keep it all the same. But I can just about get away with that. Then you just have a little bit of, probably actually 1% is a highlight. And if we go higher, because I just want that highlight on top. So when I take that back down, just about looks okay that. Has anybody got any questions? I look what I've done, and it's taken me an hour because I was messing about to start with. It's not a cheats kind of way. It's another way of working. But you can get some cool effects. Let me see what we can do with the sword. I don't really think, so if I use the very black purple but make it metallic, and do this one first. No idea if this will work. You've got to kind of really slice that across to get the highlight. It's just the tiniest bit of mist there and there. And then we'll move it up a bit, and then we can kind of give that the dark. And then can I go for it again? I suppose we could put, actually, we could put a highlight. On the purple. Then we could put the darkest one underneath. have a quick look and see what this looks like. I don't think I like it, but we'll just have a look. It's a fantasy drawing. We're just making it up. And so we'll return it to our original size and she now has well the sword is definitely made of the same thing as the buckles. So if we take the metallic off, we could then oops. See, I've just made a big mistake there. I've gone over that. So if I take that off, I'm still 1%, so. I like that. There's a bit, a lot of shadow around you can play with saturation and all sorts. I think I actually preferred the natural one that I got earlier, so I'm going to leave that. I like that. It's just natural. So we have to go back into the original dark purple and push back to, oops, and push back to a metallic. Push that over there and do the end of this sod, and that was just lucky that I got that particular. I just got that particular highlight, just what I wanted it. And I think it's pressing down. I think if you press down, you get more. But I actually quite like that. And again, it, you know, it's a colour page. But I quite like that. And so I think I've done the buckle. I think I've done them a different colour. So they need tanning up a little bit, I think. Can't mix up. I can't make mind it whether I like the brown or the. I think I possibly like the brown rather than the tan. Again, you've got to remember to take the metallic off, otherwise you'll have shiny. I think we'll be fine because this is the tan, and then I'm going to use the highlights I had before to build up some nice colour. And then you can just. Just put that little bit of colour on there. Well, it would be. So we're going to have a highlight there because it's on the end, and then possibly the highlight here. It's on the, obviously kind of a bit of a. Okay.
hell can possibly mark? And you can physically put the curl round and then take in some darker colours. So again, I'm only at 200. I like to be at 300, really. So I think I'm on my tan. I'll turn her round. So it would be different if this wasn't grayscale. Grayscale is different to work with. Oops, which is why I was going to scan in a different one. And so just finish this buckle and then I'll go to the next one. So as you can see, you know, it's not easy, it's different. It's perfect if you've got pearly hands and if you just and there are cheaper. There's a tablet you can do this with. It's £50. You just don't draw on top of it. You draw and you watch the thing. And I might actually buy. My daughter said not to. I want to buy one for graphics because she can make it move. You can make it do animation. And of course, she's doing illustration and animation, so I really wanted to do that. So I hope. Oh dear, excuse me. I always have terrible indigestion when I have. Put a really, 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 really high highlight. And there would be a high highlight on that side because that's where all the light's coming from. There's a little bit from this side. And again, you do that with your highlights. So you only know this by practice. So that's not quite as warm as I wanted, but it is in shadow. So let me have a look and twiddle around. No, it's coming along. It's coming along. But it's not quick. It's, you know, it's and it makes your hands hurt a little bit because you forget. You know, I made an awful lot of strokes on there, far more than I normally do. And I'm working with a 1%. It's got tool sizes at 1%, so you know it's not. But I like this particular one because it has a stand. Some of the stands are hundreds of pounds, so you can work at a nice natural angle. So let me have a look for a gold, and then make it metallic. And again, I've made a bit of a mistake because I'm at the middle. But if you, if we zoom in, she's got a gold star there. And you can make this metallic as well. Or we could press, there's a glitter tube. So we could have glitter tubes. There's all sorts of things on here at all, as well. Gonna take that star off because I'm not sure. She could be in a silver. She could be in a silver suit. So if we have white and we keep it metallic. Oops, I've got the wrong one on. Sorry. She could be in, and you make your brush a lot bigger. I mean, you could just do this if you wanted to. And she's in a silver. She's in a metallic suit. Excuse me, I'm just gonna have to have a coffee. I mean, that looks like a real silver suit. She could have obviously I work at 300. So she could have. Now the silver is going over the tan. So she's got kind of a bronze suit. But here it wouldn't be bronze. It would be silver. Oops, sorry. So you could, oops. Oh, just I keep catching the button because I'm not at the right angle. She could have this as a silver suit with silver straps. The more you press down, the quicker things are. This could be silver. So she could have a complete silver suit on. Shiny, shiny, shiny silver suit on. Shiny gloves. Oh dear, my little man wants something. What do you want? So she could be. What do you want? You want to sit on my knee? Are you cold? Little man's come to see me. No, sit there. You've got two fluffy blankets there. Sit down there, please. Sit. Sit. So you can do all sorts with oh, I can do a leg. Look here, that'd be good. So again, you see, once you start, if you press down, you can get some really nice effects. So that's going right around there. So she's now got some shiny silver trousers on. Depending on how hard you push down. And I intended her to have a purple. I intended her to have actually a purple suit on. Purple would be quite nice, metallic purple, but that's what I did that one with. So what I'm going to do is put her back to 100. Oh, I don't know what puppy wants. And then I'm just going to have to tap back to take all that off. And that should take me back to. Don't know where I got to. What have you done then? That was the first undo. Oh, there. Right. Oh no, I don't want to undo that. So I'm going to take all that back to there. Right. So that's where I'm going to stay. Oops. So I hope that was interesting, and I'm going to stop that particular video because it's been an hour, nearly 2 hours. So that's where she is at the moment. So all I need to do now is to
either press File and Save As. And I've already got, oh, she's untitled. And that's saved. So I can come out of there. I've no idea what that is. So here I've got Krita and I've got the Sai, Paint Tool Sai, SAI version 1. And my Sai paintings, I did Alfie in Sai. Not sure why he's lopsided, but let me just see if I can rotate. That way, no, rotate the other way. Good idea, but wrong way. Rotate that one and again. Oh, for goodness sake, Heather. Rotate. It's Control N. Sorry, just bear with me. So, this is what we did with Alfie. I will get there in a second. He's nearly right way around. He won't be because he's jumping on my knee at the moment. No, Dad, don't scratch. Right, so I'm going to save that now because I'm sick of him moving around. So I'm going to name that Alfie 2. And hopefully he's going to stay the right way around. So this is Sai, and this is wonderful because I'm going to very quick. Oh, I'll come back to this. I'll have to just stop because he's being a pest. So I can put my little pen in the top there. I can lean it that way. And because it's got like a rubberized thing, it sits quite nicely. Not sure what he wants. So thank you for watching, and I'm not going anywhere. I'm just going to end this video because it's been a couple of hours. But this is now into Sai, and I'll go a little bit through that because I've lost his eye. So thank you for watching.